Ever wonder how those animations with coin flying through speed lines are made? Well, in today's video, I'm going to show you exactly how to create that effect in Adobe After Effects. It is one of the easiest yet trendiest effects for minimal motion design, and the best part is you don't need any plugin to make it. But before we jump into the tutorial, let's quickly talk about today's sponsor, which is Monster One. With a Monster One subscription, you get access to over 600,000 design elements, from video templates and graphics to sound effects and more. And here's the cool part, the subscription costs less than Envato or almost any other platform out there. The awesome folks over at Monster One were generous enough to give me a special discount link, so make sure to grab it in the description before it disappears. Now, let's get to the video. Here we are inside of Adobe After Effects, and now let's begin. So on the first step, I want to create the speed lines for the animation. Well, to do that, I'm going to click on new composition. Let's just change the height to the double of the size that we have in here. So I'm just gonna write multiply by 2, and I'm going to change the composition name into speed lines, and let's begin. All right. In order to create the speed lines, on the first step, we need to create the solid layer. So I'm going to press Ctrl plus Y to create a new solid layer. I'm going to call it speed lines. And now on the effects and preset tab, I'm going to write the effect fractal noise, and I'm going to bring it towards the speed lines. Fractal noise is a really powerful effect, but we need to tweak it and modify it in our own version. Well, the first step I'm going to do is that I'm just going to change the noise type from the soft linear into spline. And now we can increase the contrast to, let's say, 2000, and we can decrease the brightness to 300. So in that way, we only get the white lines that we want, but this still does not look like a speed line. Well, to fix that, we need to open the transform panel. We need to turn off the uniform scaling. Now I'm just going to decrease the scale width to, let's say, 5 pixels, and then I'm going to increase the scale height to, let's say, a really big number, 4,000 should be good. And now, as you see, we have the speed lines, but the problem is that it's not moving. Well, to fix that, we are going to set an expression. So I'm going to hold Alt and I'm going to click on evolution to set an expression, and I'm going to write time multiply by 600. So this will give us an animation like this. So if you want your speed lines to be more intense, you can increase the number. However, I think the 600 works fine for me. Now you can even tweak these settings a bit further by opening the subsettings, and you can change a few parameters in here to get a different results. So this just looks fine for me. And this is going to be the speed lines, which is absolutely fine. Now it is time to design the coin. So I'm going to create a new composition, and let's just turn the height into 9020, and I'm gonna change its name to coin. All right, this is good. Now let's start with the base of the coin. So I'm gonna grab the circle tool, and I will draw a circle like this. Let's just change the color to a linear gradient. And the colors, I'm just going to set it like a bit gray and a pure black. And we are gonna just set it like this. Okay, this looks good. I'm gonna call it base. I'm gonna duplicate it. And this time I'm going to decrease its size to almost here. And we're gonna just call it solid color. And then on the last step, I'm gonna just write a dollar sign. Let's change its color. And I'm gonna set it on here. Okay, let's just fix this. All right, this looks good. Now I'm going to parent these two layers into the base layer. And let's just rename this one into middle as well. All right, now on the next step, I will turn these coins into 3D. So let's just click on the cube icon in here, and then make sure you're working on the Cinema 4D renderer. And we're gonna just open the rotation. Let's rotate it until here. You see we have a few glitches in here. That is because we need to push them a bit. outside. This is good. Now we need to create depth for this base layer. Well, to do that, we are going to simply open the geometry options and we're gonna increase the extrusion depth. All right, 68, let's just call it 70. That should be good. And we can just do the same step for the base layer as well. We can just give it a bit more depth, same as the dollar sign. And if you increase the geometry all the way, let's say to here, when you are rotating the shape, let's just open the rotation. You will see that this will extend from the back side. So let's just set it on here, almost on 100, and almost on 100, I think it should be good. And we're gonna just repeat the same step for the extrusion as well. So 19 should be good on this side as well. All right, we have the base. Now it is time to sort of make it better. We want to create a few reflections on this coin. So when we want to colorize it, we will have more option and better result at the end. Well, to do that, what I'm going to do is that I'm just going to select on the new, and then I'm going to select light. Well, on the type, I'm gonna set it on point. The intensity right now is just gonna be 300. I'm not gonna touch it. And the color, let's just leave it for white for now. I'm gonna explain a bit on detail later on this video. And the radius is set on 500 and fall of distance is set on 2000. Okay, this is good. Now we need to arrange the light in a way that creates reflection. And we need to duplicate the layers at the light layers as much as possible to create that reflection. Right now you see this is just too intense. So I'm going to decrease the intensity to, you know, for example, 120. And then I'm gonna just duplicate this layer again. I'm gonna just create a reflection in here, a reflection in here. And even we can just change the camera. Let's say it on top, and we can use these controllers to set the lighting from above. And lastly, what we can do is that let's just get back to the default view, which is in here. We're gonna parent these lights into the base layer. Okay, right now it's a little bit too intense, so we're just gonna play with these lights a bit, or delete a few of them, reducing the intensity to create the better reflection. But we can use the rotation to see how this reflection looks when we are rotating. So you see when we are rotating, we don't have almost any colors happening in here. So let's just quickly fix these issues by increasing the lights and repositioning them in a way that gives us a better reflection. So now, as you see, this is the reflection that I got for the coin, and it's super amazing in my opinion. Now we get to the important part, which is the colorizing and making the install for this type of coins. And as you know, creating an install is super crucial and super important for this type of designs. But let's just create the main composition for now. And I'm gonna just bring the speed lines in here. And then we're gonna just bring the coin on top of it. Right now, as you see, this is the coin that we have in here, and this is the speed lines that we have beneath it. So it's a bit, you know, too rough. Let's just get back and quickly fix these. Okay, this looks better. Now, in order to colorize it, we can use a lot of effects to make it better. The reason why we are creating these layers in black and white is because After Effects tend to treat the colors as black and white. So having the layers on black and white will help you to colorize it better. So for example, we can add the Triton effect on the coin, and now we can just simply change the color to what you like. So let's say I'm gonna go with purple. And then you can just even take this style further by right clicking on the cone layer. In layer styles, we can select inner glow. And then you can increase the size a bit. And then change the color mode from the screen to color dodge. And then you can get the color like this. Okay. Now let's just go and animate these base layer as well. And I'm gonna just animate it for one entire rotation in here. Let's just apply these standard easings. And you could see that now it's colorized super well. Now you can see it's colorized super well. And you can even take this design further by adding a deep glow effect. So if you have the deep glow effect, you can just add it. You can change the radius to 400 and then the exposure to 0.1. And then you can, in input section, you can just change the threshold to add a sudden glow into it. But if you do not have the deep glow effect, you can just simply use the manual glow effect, which will not give you the good results as good as the deep glow, but it is still something that you can try. And you can just reduce the glow intensity a bit, and then you can increase the glow radius to get the look that you want. But even there, you can use so many effects. So for example, right now we have colorized it with Triton, and this time we can use the Colorama effect to style this coin. So for example, I'm gonna just apply the Colorama effect. I'm gonna push it above the deep glow, and then we can go into the output cycle and we can choose different color sets, which will give us, you know, a better result. So for example, if we set it on solar green, you will see that we will have an effect like this, or we can just change it into, you know, a lot of colors, and each one of these colors will give you a unique sense of design for your animation. All right, let's just reverse everything back to the Triton. Alright, in editing process, I just remembered two things that I wanted to share with you, and I forgot to do it in the main video. The first one is that if you open the coin composition, you can also change the colors in here, and this will affect how the entire shape will look like with the color grading. So if you want to have a different approach and you want to have different sets of color for your coin design, you can just change the color of the coins and the color of the lights, and this will give you a different result. But the important thing that I wanted to share with you is that how to make sort of the reflection for the speed of the coin. Well, to do that, I'm just going to duplicate this comp, and I'm gonna change its name to speed. Let's just move it beneath the coin layer, and then on the effects and preset tab, I'm just gonna add the directional blur effect into the speed, and we are going to increase the speed sort of like this. Let's just solo it so you guys can see better. But before we do that, we're gonna draw a mask like this, and then we're gonna just change the blur directions to, let's say, 180 degrees. And with that being said, all we need to do now is just we need to reposition it. And then we can use the scale, and we can scale it like this to create that sort of the reflection And lastly, we can just parent it to the main coin. And this will be the coin with the reflection. Alright, here we are at the end of this video, and I hope you have enjoyed it. If you have enjoyed this video, don't forget to leave out a like and subscribe to the channel, as it would help me out a lot. Thank you so much. Goodbye.